Alright, I talk about objectification. I guess I'm really heavy into the metals at the moment. The metal consequence, drip up, just drip drizzle. Consequence in my mind, in my body, affectants. Some metals making more compassion, others making more luxurious state of mind, others making an incredible horny, other metals being insatiable. What are these metals that are coming from this particular, you know, radioactive fallout? I believe some are completely, what is the wording? I would say they are loosening of inhibitions, not necessarily great for certain persons. Some people can handle the loosening of inhibitions and the consequences thereof, others cannot. So it is a danger, especially when it enters into the morality state and maybe you are like a strict devoutist and all of a sudden you're a total, complete, whoever. This type of a moment change in your life, it could absolutely be the fall of the metals from the sky. I think we are just waiting, you know, waiting for this what's going to upset us next. So I don't want to live there. I don't want to live in the upset of the metal of any metal, actually, even in the room. I find metal itself is a disbalancer, and unfortunate. I have to use it in the cooking, don't I? I have to use it to the cooking. And I'm not a rawologist like some of those persons are, and good for them to be the raw out there. They only eat the raw food. They don't have to. I say they are intertaking metals, even to their eyes. All of us are taking metals in, even to the eyes, because we are a reflector there, a mirror. I believe it does go into, gosh, I look funny, I'm almost shining, I put the beeswax on my face. Like the wax museum woman. No, the reflector. The reflector of the effect. What is it affecting you? You know, are you like some type of I don't know. And you can't really say right away if it's making you angry. You can't really say, you know, I have so much metal in the room, it's making me angry. You can't just pin it to that. But it can possibly have an effect. Maybe even make you feel more paranoid or more exotically busy. That you have to be doing something to succeed, that you have to tap into an effect. You know, chrome yourself out a little. So it's essentially like inhaling chrome right there and there. And what it is doing to the mind, inhaling it into your mind. We already know the deadliness of it in the powder form as an oxide. I'm just entertaining the reflector as it being a deadly also. In conjunction with all of those. So yeah, I think I'm affected. I think I'm a horrid person. In my mind thought intertake, meaning oftentimes. But can I blame myself for this? Or can I only, can I have this outlook now? That it is the emphatica, what do we call it? Heavy metal rains. All of this, they call it the acid. They call it the acid. They call it the heavy metal rains. They call it the radioactive fallout. They call it all of these goodies, you know. Climbing higher and higher, and then they have something now called a radcon, and I'm looking, oh yeah, radcon, and nobody can tell me what it actually means, you know, level 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, is getting excited and hypey, you know, and radcons. I'm like, well, okay, this, I don't know. I don't want to get into it anymore. I don't want to get into the hype of a radcon. That's because in a way you would never really know, do we? We never really know when these waves are having extra heavy. Like last night in particular, from the day before, I have had many, many apples in the kitchen that completely are destroyed from all of a sudden overnight activity in turning into, what do we call it? I mean, it just turns into a, oh my gosh, there is the thing where it ages fast, very fastly. Yeah, rogue apples, all of a sudden bruises everywhere. And so I'm like, well, what's the deal? What's the deal? This one night, you know, and it feels like it's been 10 or 15. So in a way, it is like a cloud that has gone through, an energy cloud that has gone through that's been a pretty bad one. So yeah, I look at this all the time at the food supply itself, and right there it is in that action. As an identifier that, oh, we're having heavy metal now extra. And I guess I call radioactive isotopes also heavy metal. What was the answer now? Oh, I was trying to remove them. I was trying, I know, I'm out there, a big query, big question. Oh, stupid. Stupid, never asked the question. Yeah. How do you remove these particulates? I guess, like I said a long time ago, live underneath the ocean, underneath the sand belt itself. Live underneath the ocean and live somehow purificated underneath everything, underneath the entire planet. Or sail away in a spaceship and try to find another oxygenated zone that is free of this consequence of our particular time. Because if this particular time has turned us into this Borgic, today I'm just like a commercial woman, and that's going to be my agenda. You know, what are they eating? What are those women eating? What are those men eating? That is their satisfy. Do they all live in the same neighborhood, you know? They all had the same clouds go by. We can't say that, no, because they would have the childhood also, the childhood build-up zone, like, you know, how many black flags did you have in the house and all of that, squirt with a paranoia gun. Did you have that type of father, that type of energy? Did you have these over-ant killer parents? So yeah, you got to go into this also as being a personality Borg intaker, which personality direction you are. And yeah, I don't know. Yeah, the compassionate state one is a new one for me, where I see actions of persons dying, and I actually am not I'm not in a cry for it. I'm not in an agony. I am actually not not comfortable with that state of myself, to be completely like blasé. The blasé into the humor, even. When you have the blasé into the humor, it becomes, well, what metal evil is in my body now? So my only thought it could be the answer. I do not accept it as me, true, in my personality. I believe something has affected it, just like the whiteout prescripta, the whiteout prescriptas. I had an uncle. He was in the first experiments there at Fort Bliss, and they gave him the Agent Orange. They gave him the Agent Orange. I experimented on him particularly. They even gave him the, I guess they call it like a lobotomy electric shock thing. So he had all of these terribles, and I hope somebody out there in my family goes and finds a pickup for that. Maybe there's a lawsuit you can get back on him and his terrible life, them using him as an experimental animal. In the end, they gave him only a drawer filled. Drawer filled with so many heavy metal drugs that it was unbelievable, actually, to have that many different types of names and labels and white pills all in association in one little tiny drawer. But yes, they gave him Agent Orange. I believe it was injections. So yeah, I believe these metals are absolutely distractants, distractants to our particular truth of who we really wanted ever to be. They become a fight to find ourselves. Who are we really, on a person basis? And that is our future consequence. Is fighting that aggression, because some of these are so easy, man. So some are so easy, they play you.